In the Sengoku Jidai, the age of the country at war, the Sanada, who was not a major clan, created not one, but two legends in that epic age. The first was Sanada Masayuki, which we have done a video series on already. And the other is this series' topic of interest, Sanada Yukimura, whose real name was Sanada Nobushige. Yukimura being a name given in a later period when he was romanticized for his deeds. Other nicknames include a hero that comes once in 100 years, Crimson, Demon of War, the last Sengoku hero, etc. Nobushige was the second son of Sanada Masayuki, and like many sons of lesser clans, his service to the clan was to be sent as a hostage to stronger clans. When the Tokugawa became hostile to the Sanada over Numata Castle, which the Tokugawa had promised to the Hojo, but the Sanada refused to return, Sanada Nobushige was sent to the Uesugi clan to gain their help, his guardian being Suda Mitsuchika, who wrote a letter saying how in return for the hostage, a force was sent to aid the Sanada. Tokugawa Ieyasu's attack on Ueda Castle failed, and by the end of the year, Sanada Masayuki turned his diplomatic genius on Toyotomi Hideyoshi to bring a quick end to the conflict. This also allowed the Sanada clan to leave the service of the Uesugi, as they too were vassals of the Toyotomi. Thus, Nobushige was sent to serve under the Toyotomi instead. He must have been exemplary, as under this service, he married the daughter of a senior Toyotomi retainer, Otani Yoshisugu. Also, when Fushimi Castle was being built, and the Sanada clan were ordered to provide men for the construction, he too was named alongside his father and older brother, which showed his standing in the clan, even though he was a younger son. Years would go by, and the Sanada would, due to diplomatic reasons, become allies to the Tokugawa in the prelude to the Battle of Sekigahara. In fact, the Sanada clan was even on its way to Aizu to aid Tokugawa forces in the area. But then, Ishida Mitsunari brought 13 charges against the Tokugawa, and all were approved by the Bugyo regents, who were ruling on behalf of Hideyoshi's heir, and sent the Sanada a request to rethink their alliances. Masayuki complied with the request and brought his forces and Nobushige home to Ueda Castle with him. But ever the far-sighted daimyo, Masayuki left his older son, Nobuyuki, with Ieyasu's forces, thus ensuring that no matter who won, the Sanada clan would survive. And this, of course, led to Ieyasu declaring Nobuyuki would inherit all Sanada lands if he won the war. And what followed almost changed the course of Japanese history, when Tokugawa Hidetada, heir to Ieyasu, decided to try to take Ueda Castle with his 38,000 strong force, instead of just pinning its 2,000 strong garrison and speeding to aid his father in the Battle of Sekigahara as planned. The siege lasted 8 whole days and ended in failure, after which Hidetada pinned the forces at Ueda but reached Sekigahara too late to participate in the close fight of a battle, almost costing himself the future shogunate and his head. Now, being on the losing side, both Masayuki and Nobushige were not in great positions to keep their head, but thankfully the strategic loyalty of Nobuyuki spoke on his family's behalf, and they were given clemency and exiled to Kudoyama in Kii province. Nobushige was 32 when this happened. For the most part, it was a life of pleasure, writing poetry, but battle called in the samurai's heart. And when Hideyori, Hideyoshi's heir, called on Ronin to support his cause, and Ieyasu was preparing to attack him in Osaka Castle, Nobushige responded by sneaking out of Kudoyama and joined Hideyori as one of his top commanders. Next time, we will see his exploits in the siege of Osaka Castle. So if you like content like this, like, subscribe, and come back for more. Till next word.